Hello everybody, my name is Bartłomiej Śnieżyński, I'm from AGH, University of Science and Technology, Kraków, Poland. And today I would like to present you results of our collaboration project, Security Aware Job Allocation in Mobile Cloud Computing. It was done by Piotr Nawrocki, Jakub Pajor, Joanna Kołodziej and me. I will start with motivation. So the mobile cloud computing can be very beneficial for mobile cloud users. However, just as in a conventional cloud system, the use of cloud for mobile devices poses a lot of questions in terms of security and trust issues. One of the most challenging problems is the flow of mobile tasks related to remote cloud services, is the security of communication, service security, and reliability of cloud resources. In order to support security-aware resource mapping and deal with requirements, secure mobile cloud resource management systems are needed that will be able to continuously manage the reservation process by monitoring the current service and the data requests, amending future service and data requests, and automatically adjusting schedules to accommodate the dynamically changing demand for resources. Here we can see the concept of secure job allocation process. So, as input, we get task to be executed. And in the first step, we make security filtration, which means that we check the expectations of the security level for a given task, and we select services and connections we can use that will provide appropriate security level. Then we move to the procedure which predicts the resource consumption. We can use models that for any service that will be used to execute the task. It could be a cloud service, it could be a service that is executed locally on the mobile device. We predict how much time will it take or how much battery we will use if the task is executed there. Then we can make optimization. So we select the best connection and the best service. We execute the task there and collect data, how much energy we have used, how much time it took, and we store this data in experience database. From time to time, we can execute machine learning algorithms that will transform this experience into models. And these new updated models can be used then for resource consumption prediction. Here you can see the filtration algorithm. We get information about all possible connections, all possible services where the job can be executed. Here is the information if VPN can be used and data confidentiality level. And the algorithm returns set of connections that are secure enough and set of filtered services. If we don't expect high security, all connections and all services can be used. And in other cases, here we select only these that provide enough security. Here is the algorithm for the whole system. It's the algorithm for service execution selection. And again, input is set of possible connections and services. Can we use VPN, data confidentiality level, task that will be executed, currently available connections, model that can be used to predict resources consumption. ExperienceDB is the database where information about results of tasks execution is stored, and user preferences. Should we optimize security, or maybe time is more important? And result we return from this function output of the tasks. So at the beginning, we initialize our system. We are training here the context model using ExperienceDB. From time to time, we can update models. Here we filter security policies using the algorithm discussed before. Then we predict resources consumption and choose optimal service. Next, the task is executed on this optimal service. We need to store the result of the execution and resources that were consumed. All this information is stored in Experience database, and we can return the result. We have evaluated our approach to check what's the impact of security mechanisms on the efficiency of services in mobile cloud computing. We used a scenario in which optical character recognition service was installed in mobile cloud. And the OCR procedure could be executed on mobile device, in the cloud, or on a local PC. To implement OCR service, we used Tesseract OCR, an open source engine, which was deployed to the cloud, local PC, and on the mobile phone under the Android operating system. To measure the influence of the security module, and the security level achieved, we used three priority preference configurations. Time and security is in this configuration, security is the top priority, and if possible, time is optimized. The second configuration is time. Here only execution time is optimized. And the random decision is just to compare the results. The decision is made randomly. Here we can see the results. On the left, we have time. So we can see that for time and security configuration, time is almost twice as big as for time priority configuration. And random decision is in the middle. But when we compare the achieved security level, it was represented by a number between 0 and 4. 4 was the maximal security. We were able to achieve for time and security configuration value above 3, while time priority configuration achieved security level just above 2. So it was lower than for random decisions, for which the level was 2.4. So to summarize, we have proposed a novel security-aware job flow model in mobile computational clouds. And this model makes it possible to take into account security parameters of the services, connections used, and of the data processed. The proposed algorithm filters out configurations that are not sufficiently secure. It was the filtration algorithm. And from the remaining one, it selects one with the lowest predicted resource consumption. Experimental results show that our system works well and improves the security level of computations significantly compared to configurations in which computation time is the highest priority. Thank you very much. If you have questions, you can write emails. Here are our addresses. And I wish you a nice day.